Yeah.
Look, I'm here just to support the workout.
Awesome. Put an arm across the front. and everything. Keep those arms pumping. All right, so we're going to do some wall climbers here. 3, 2, 1, take it up. It's all wall climbers. Here we go. Good. Get those arms stretching. We're going to do some military jacks. 2, 1, and go. There it is. Excellent. See, full body.
She's extending a right arm, left leg, left arm, right leg. Now, sometimes when we do this, our one knee wants to pull in as our other extends. That's the no-no. We don't want to make that happen. We want to make sure that we keep those legs propped and right above the hips as we extend. Big exhale, right? This is really good for the core, really good for the back. Very well done. Juan has got dive bombers for us. Oh yeah, get in that pike position, and you're going to dive bomb that floor like you're crawling under a fence. Very good, very good. Go right down there, and you're going to come back up to a plank and then pike, okay? So Juan's going to go sideways for a second so we can see this in a slide motion, you guys. So as you're coming under, he gets really low. It's nice to control, but never actually touches the floor. If you can't get that low, you're just going to go, you can go a little bit less, or you can come to a plank position. And then drop to your knees, do a push-up, and then go back to that pike. That's going to be your alternative for dive bomber if that was uncomfortable for you to go down. Very good, very good, very good. Curl, squat, press. Grab those weights, my friends. Curl them up to your shoulders, squat down low, and press it tall above head. Cindy's got that rotation. She's going rotating into that forward position with her overhead press. If you just want to curl, squat, press straight on up with that hammer press, you can. This is yours. Find something to curl with. Go grab some one-man stones from your garden. Go grab a cast iron pot. There you go. Make sure when you squat that you've got your body parallel with the ground. All right, you're doing these demos with us. So, wide flat chest press. We're back on the ground. You're going to take those weights with a slight bend in your arm, like Barbie doll arms, what it's called. Open those weights up long until probably the back of the top of your arm touches the floor. And then a center chest press, and when they're back together, and you pump it out in the center. So let's watch this happen. A wide fly, nice and wide, and then a center chest press. That's all you gotta do. And with that wide fly, you wanna make sure you aren't going so far that you're feeling any tension right here. You just wanna start to feel it right there on the top of your pec. Bring it back in, center chest press. Bump that out, nicely done. If you don't have any of those weights, you can always do a diamond push-up. It's gonna be your alternative. Spider plank. Hooray! In the high plank position, she's gonna be right knee to right elbow and then back again. Left knee to left elbow and back again. If she wants to go into a low plank position, can she? Yeah, absolutely she can. Low plank, right knee, right elbow, left knee, left elbow. That booty better stay low. That thing is gonna want to pop up in the air every time you bring your knees in. Try and keep it down. That's part of the strength of this move. And now we have one left. Iso bike abs. So you are going to just hold that across your body. Right elbow, left knee, hold it. Keep your back nice off the ground. And when I say halfway, you just switch. You are just holding those moves. That's it, iso bike abs. Crunch, a little crunch in there. So one, I'm gonna give you both the transition moves. The first one. The first one's gonna be Russian twists. Body is still big and long, there you go. And we are going to make sure that we've got left, right, torso rotation, notch the arms. And then our second transition move is a V up. So you're gonna be extended nice and long. And you're going to reach for your reach for your toes, you guys. If you can't reach your toes, that's okay. Bend your knees. It's all in the flexibility that you have. If not, just do crunches. There we go. There we go. It's your workout today. Squat, tall press overhead.
Yep, you got the stomach. Yeah. Oh yeah. Yep, just making sure we're all trying to look together. It's not a giant number of levels that we touch. We're trying to work up. Red up, all together. So 1, 2, 3, up. When the last time someone gave you an applause? It feels pretty good. But let's start with our dead guys. We get those up. Get those out of the way first. Sometimes just waking up and getting that bed is the hardest part. Again, I applaud you if you do that.
Yeah.
Everything else is just going to be straight to the top. You're ready, dead bugs, and those are the exercises. In 3, 2, 1, and go. We got dead bugs right here. Exhale. You guys have 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! Good job. All right. Breathe, my friends. 5 seconds to go. And we've got 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, over to that knee up.
Start climbing down.
So you notice how we did some wall climbers, some mountain climbers, some squat jumps. We're going to add those and those sit-ups into our rotation moves for the last round. Sound good? So we still have our shoes, we still have the ups. We're going to throw some cardio a little bit in there for you. Sound awesome?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I was going to stand up too, but it's dead bugs, so.
Oh, yeah.
Fly, so I'm gonna press. I don't know. Blend that back to the left. Work, breathe. Big long breath, left come back, forward down. Onto that leg, position lift up to a little pose. All right. Breathe. And then exhale, just to heal. Keep saying breathe, go to the mind to breathe. And it's so natural, yeah. You know that, don't hold your breath. Don't hold your breath where it's at.
Endeavors, you are amazing.